Islam is a total lie.
Okay. You can't prove that.
Let's just let them substantiate.
Islam is a total lie.
Alright, cool.
Islam says that Islamic Allah sent out 124,000 prophets across the world throughout time. 124,000. Yeah. Can you name a few of these outside of the Bible?
Outside of the Bible or the Quran?
Outside of the Bible.
It doesn't mean that it
exists. No, no, no. Question is simple. Question is simple. If there were 124,000 prophets. So let's deal with this. 124,000 people, prophets. I'm assuming you would appreciate that they would have had signs and wonders. No, 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 no. Wait, wait. 124,000. 124,000 people with signs and wonders and so on throughout time, and you are saying there exists no evidence of any of them outside of the Bible? Does that?
Just the Bible. The Quran.
Well, the Quran doesn't give any prophet. So leave behind the Quran.
It gives names of prophets. Of course, it gives names.
The Quran does not. No, no. Musa is not a name.
Musa is not a name.
What do you mean it's not a name?
Moses.
The de-Latinized name, Musa.
Musa, is that a Hebrew name?
I don't know.
Musa. Moses is a Hebrew prophet. Okay. His works are here. No problem. In the Bible.
The Quran
is, as we are talking about so far, is a book which doesn't give you meaningful statements.
Okay.
Bring them bring all the statements of the Quran, you don't learn much. And so the point simply is, let's leave behind the Quran. Let's leave behind the Quran. We are talking about the Bible. Outside of the Bible, do you have any evidence for 124,000 prophets?
What does that say?
It means Islam is a whole bucket full of lies.
No. Why though?
In the Bible, do you know how many prophets are there in the Bible about?
How many?
Approximately. Approximately.
I don't know. I'm asking.
You tell us.
Approximately about 50 prophets.
Okay.
50 great men of God. Approximately. And what do we know from these 50 people? What is the evidence for the 50 people? How many people follow them?
Yeah.
You can see today about 1 billion plus people follow them.
Right.
If that is the case for about 50 people, how about for 124,000? Can you even believe this? Can you grapple with this, please? For 50 people, if the impact that they have had is such a monumental impact, just for about 50 people, how much could you expect from about 124,000? How much could you expect? Excuse me, how much could you expect?
Do you know what we believe about those prophets?
Impact from 124,000 people, prophets.
So the names that you're quoting in the Bible.
How much can you expect? Yes.
The names in the Bible that you're talking about, why do you believe that they're accurate? Why do you believe that those people existed? What I'm asking is, why do you trust the Bible, basically? That's my question.
How does that have anything to do with the 124,000 question I'm asking?
Because you're saying that there's names in the Bible that talk about prophets, and you're saying that those names don't exist in the Quran, and so therefore the Quran is a lie. What I'm trying
That's
to say,
not the point I'm making. You've got my point wrong.
Many inconsistencies within it. For example,
give me your name again, please.
Zechariah. The genealogies in Mark and Luke, for example, they're different. So therefore, if there's different lineage going from Abraham to Jesus, if the lineage is 14 in Luke, for example, and multiple more in I think it's Matthew, then how do you reconcile the differences in names?
Zechariah, do you understand the word deviation?
Yeah.
Detraction.
Right. Yeah.
Understand those words?
So,
I'm asking you to defend Islam.
So let's speak.
You're now talking about the Bible.
Loudly.
About Islam, the question. Hey, brother.
Have a dialogue with him now.
Zechariah.
Look, listen, I just want to have a discussion. Don't talk like really loud.
Well, there are many other people here, so. I'd like to speak to many other people. Don't worry.
Okay,
so Zechariah, the question is simple. If...
But I asked you a question first, though.
Whoa. Who asked the question first? Was it him or me? Who asked the question first?
You asked me and I answered, and then I gave
you... No, you didn't answer me anything. I'm asking you, if 50 people, around 50 people, could have caused the impact that they caused, how much could you expect from about 124,000 similar prophets? How many? The Islam says, Islam says, you said,
I know you're preaching, but you're not discussing.
You said, you
have to listen, or do you want to talk? Exactly.
I want clarifications. I want you to understand, Zechariah. I want you to understand that Islam spreads a whole load of lies.
I believe that.
I want you to understand that.
I believe that you believe that.
I'm not asking you for my. I'm not asking you to empathize with me. I'm asking you to listen to my points. Evidence that I'm providing. The evidence that I'm providing, I'd like you to listen to.
I'm saying the evidence you're providing is from a Bible that's been corrupted. That's what I'm trying to
say. The evidence I'm providing is from Islam, not from the Bible. Islam says, no. Listen to me, please. You clearly have misunderstood. Islam says, not the Bible. Islam says, Islamic Allah sent 124,000 prophets across the world. Islam says that.
Yes, we know.
Do you know of any of these?
And that makes it wrong. Why does that make it wrong?
Clearly.
No, why? Why does that make it wrong and a lie? Why does all the prophecies, all the scientific miracles, all of the mathematical impossibilities...
Which mathematical impossibility? What are you talking about?
For example, in the Quran, I can't point it out, like in a verse, but in the Quran, if you look, there's words such as... I've written it down, but there's words that come, for example, day. The word day, yaum, comes 365 times in the whole Quran.
Does that make it?
The word month comes 12 times. The word, there's specific like repentance.
What does that mean?
All of these words become, when you compile the whole Quran at one, in one, it shows that even a man that was illiterate, didn't understand numbers, letters, anything, he made a whole Quran which came over 23 years, and there happened to be words that came exactly the same times mathematically. That didn't have to do with the same verse. Like day happened to be 365 times in the whole Quran. That's just one example of the mathematical.
Please read verses 83 to 86, please.
Right, well, if I'm going to do that, then you got to read.
Please read. Please read.
Then you got to read your own Bible.
Please read.
If you're going
to
shoot.
Now, I like to see the mathematical wonders here, the scientific wonders here.
He has a double standard because he doesn't even realize the Bible says that the world is 6,000 years old. He doesn't realize that the Bible is inconsistent in its genealogy.
Please read.
Here's the thing.
I'd like to see how wonderful this Quran is. Please read.
Do I know Arabic? Do you know Arabic?
This is English, don't worry. This is English. This is an English translation, please don't worry. Please read this. Would you like to read this?
No, I do not want to. Zechariah, I don't speak Arabic, so I'm not well versed enough to explain the verse. If I'm not, don't know Arabic, I can't explain.
I thought you were explaining to me about 365 and 12 and everything else.
Mathematical. I can do that because I don't need to know Arabic to do that. I do need to know
Arabic. Do you need to know Arabic to read an English text?
I do need to know Arabic to be able to transliterate what exactly.
I'm not asking you to transliterate. I'm asking you to read some English statements.
You are, because then you're going to.
English.
I'm not, because
Zechariah,
not
English.
The original way it was revealed.
English.
What was the Bible revealed?
Are you an English speaker, sir? Can you read English? Please, can you read this for us?
Are you a Muslim? Don't take from me. He's a liar. Don't take from me. He's already been.
Don't listen to them. They can't think for themselves. Please read.
I'm not going to let you speak, so don't take it from me. Thank you.
You don't want to read. Are you a Muslim, sir?
No.
This is your Quran, sir.
Speak to somebody else in Arabic.
What's that? Well, that's the Quran.
He's not going to let you.
If you translate the Quran from Arabic into English, what do you get? Translation. But what is the content? Where is the content from? Is this from Harry Potter? Is this from The Lord of the Rings? What's that? What's that? It's a human translation. Do you know of any translations which is not human? So clearly we are happy with human translations. So can I please ask you, sir, what's that?
Thank you.
Have I ever read the original text in Arabic? Why should I care? Even the English does not make much sense. Why should I care to read in Arabic? Excuse me, sir. Please answer my simple question. Would you be bold enough to read the English translation of the Quran? Would you be bold enough? Or are you ashamed, sir? Are you ashamed of your Quran, sir? Are you not ashamed of your Quran? Then can you please read this for us? We need your help. We really need your help. That's what we're trying to do here.
Why are you imposing on
me? Which Muslim here can read English? Anyone who can read English?
Read your own Bible. You're talking to this problem.
What? Okay, please. Okay, see, you can help us, yeah? Hey, please answer this.
As I said,
please read.
I don't know Arabic, so how can I give you an accurate
He doesn't know Arabic, and that's precisely why we have got him an English translation. To read an English translation, what language do you need to know, Darren?
German.
German, maybe? You can read. If you know English, you can read this.
I don't think you understand what I'm trying to say to you.
I don't understand. That's precisely.
You keep saying the same thing. Just read, bro. I don't know.
Can anyone read English? Are you happy to read this English translation of the Quran?
No, we don't. We can't.
Why is it that Muslims are so ashamed to read their own Quran?
No,
why is this the case?
Go ask somebody that knows Arabic.
Why is this the case? Are you an Arabic speaker?
No. Not a native Arabic speaker, no.
And can you read Arabic?
I can read it, I can't translate it.
So you can read Arabic, you won't understand what it says?
Not yet, I'm trying to
learn. Clearly then you can't be a Muslim.
Not
what?
True.
Well, wait a second. If you can't read...
A Muslim is submission to God. Doesn't mean that I have to know Arabic to be a Muslim.
Did you hear what just happened here? A Muslim is someone who doesn't think. Muslim is someone who doesn't read this and try and evaluate. That's not who a Muslim is. A Muslim is someone who blindly submits.
That is not what a Muslim is.
That's his confession.
Somebody that submits to God.
But you're implicitly saying, Zechariah, that for you to be a Muslim, you don't have to read the Quran.
No, you're inferring. You're putting words in my mouth.
Okay, so as a Muslim, let me ask you this again. Well, of course you need to believe in the Bible for you to be a Christian. If you don't read and believe in the Bible, how can you be a Christian? Question to you again, please.
Accept God rationally without a book to hold.
Explain to me rationally, how does Islamic Allah exist? Please explain to me rationally.
Well, if you think about it, everything in the world is made up of things that could exist or could not exist, i.e. contingent things, right? So right now, you're a contingent being, I'm a contingent being, because I came from something else. I was caused by something else. And that chain, that regression, can't go on for infinity. So therefore, there has to be a... Do you want to analyze it or do you want to hear my...
I'm listening.
I'm explaining as to why God needs to exist.
No. The question asked was, why do you think Islamic Allah exists?
No.
Islamic Allah is not any one God. He's the God of the Quran.
But before the Quran came, people were still Muslims if they believed in God. They were still judged accountably. They were still judged.
Can you believe what is happening here?
People before.
Would you believe that?
Yes. People that believed in God before the Quran were still believed in God. It doesn't mean.
Do you know what makes someone a Muslim today? Let's put it this way. Islamic State went to Mosul. In Mosul, there were Christians. Yes. Christians believed in how many gods?
Three.
One. Oh, three, that's one. Your fantasy idea.
There's Unitarian Christians.
Are you a Christian, brother? Are you a Christian, brother? Yes. How many gods do you believe in?
One God.
Are you a Christian, that's brother? Right. How many gods do you believe in?
Father, the Son.
Excuse me, sir. You may have your counting issues. Learning mathematics might be a bit problematic for you. But deal with them when you deal with your primary school education. A Christian is telling you, another Christian is telling you, and I, as another Christian, am telling you, Christians believe in one God. Let me come back to you. Zechariah, let me come back to you.
Sure, okay.
Went to Mosul, the Islamic militants who went there did not say, oh, you believe in one God, and therefore you are a Muslim, we leave you alone. Is that what they did?
Excuse me. I don't know.
You don't know what Mosul is? Where Mosul is?
No, Iraq.
Islamic State?
Sure. What does that have to do with me saying that you have to believe
in God? Said anyone who believes in one God is a Muslim. That's what you said. By that definition, now you come to submit to Allah.
To one God. Islamic. Allah is one God.
Zechariah, let's do this again.
Yeah.
Please don't confuse me. It's a simple experiment. Let's go through this one simple time.
I'll make the claim because you're talking about the claim I make. So let me
who
make it again.
Who is a Muslim?
Yeah, let him make the statement.
I just wanted to make a
claim. Your claim?
Do you believe in one God?
Who is a Muslim?
Okay, then he's a Muslim. Do you believe in one God?
I am a Christian. I am not a Muslim.
People that came before Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who believed in one God, who came to it rationally, if you believe in the fitrah, which is what an innate disposition towards God is, people that came before Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam believed in that innate fitrah, believed in a God, believed in a creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will judge them on the day of judgment justly, and because they believe in a God means that they're going to go to heaven because they're Muslim. Because revelation revelation didn't exist then, you can't judge them on a revelation they never heard, right? Just for example, if there's a tribe, like there's an isolated tribe right now, can't remember the name, off the coast of Sri Lanka, if they've never heard of the revelation of Islam, and yet they believe in a God, God will...
Did you hear how anti-Semitic this guy is?
No. Well, how hard is anti-Semitic?
Before Islam, there was no revelation.
Who's funding
claims
you?
This guy. Before Islam, there is no revelation.
How can you say
would you go and say that to a Jew, sir?
How can you say
excuse me, sir. Excuse me, sir. Would you go and say that to a Jew?
I'm going to ask you a question.
Did you say that or not? Before Islam, was there a revelation or not?
Before the Quran?
Yes.
Before the Quran, there was, of course, the Injil, the Torah. Yes. I'm saying before anything. Before the Torah, before the Bible.
Before anything. Before what?
Before
anything.
Any revelation. Before the Torah, before the Bible, before the Quran. If you believed in a God before that, then you be grant, then God will judge you goodly. Goodly, justly, sorry. Because you believed in a God. And you can do that rationally. You don't need a book to believe in a God.
So, come back. Let's come back. Let's come back.
To believe in the certain attributes of God, like
omnipotence. Let's come back to this again.
Exactly. That's when you need
answer, please. Answer me, please. I heard what you said. I'm not a parrot. I heard what you said. I'm now going to move on to the next question. The question to you.
Do you know what anti-Semitic means?
The question is.
What is anti-Semitic mean?
Well, ignoring the identity of the Jews in any way, shape, or form. You inadvertently said. Because Islam teaches you that, you inadvertently said that before Islam there was no revelation. You said that, sir. You said that. Now, coming back.
Just wait. I just want to, do you want to hug me? Do you want to just discuss? Do you want to just be civil? Don't shout. I just want to have a clear discussion.
I'm speaking to many people. Excuse me. Zechariah, did I so far say to you, listen to me, please.
All right, sure, listen.
So far, did I dictate as to how you should speak? Did I do that?
No.
Speak civil, man.
What did I do? Excuse me. Wait. I asked you questions.
Yes.
And allowed you to answer in the way you want to answer.
Yeah.
Did I not?
Yeah, sure.
That's, that, excuse me. Did I not?
Yeah,
did I not?
Did. I
what did you do? What did you do?
I said,
so far, three or four times, you're telling me how I should speak. Is that a sensible thing to do?
I'm telling you to speak civilly.
He's trying to divert. He's
trying to divert. I know you.
What does civilly have to do with my sound? What does civilly have to do with your sound?
Just the sound, the fact that you don't let me speak and you're just talking over me. I say something and you call me anti-Semitic, and then when I try to justify, like you're doing now.
Can I let you know why I said you were anti-Semitic?
Yes.
Because you made a statement saying before Islam there was no revelation. You said that. When you say that, you are denying the identity of the Jews, which is what Islam has taught you to do.
That the Torah and the Bible existed before the Quran. You put words in my mouth and you insinuate.
It's all on record, don't worry.
Yeah, I know.
If you made a mistake, that's fine. If you made a mistake, if you want to correct, that's fine. That's fine. Let's move on. The question simply...
I'll happily move on if you just accept that.
The question...
You don't know what anti-Semitic means as well.
The question simply...
What does anti-Semitic mean?
Anti-Semitism includes denying the identity of the Jews in any way, shape or form. Also, denying their history in any way, shape or form. Also, that is part of anti-Semitism. So when you deny the fact that Jews got the Torah before you... Do you understand? Clearly, you don't know what identity means. Clearly, you don't know what identity means. That's fine. We can move on.
Yeah, let's move on.
Coming back to you. Islamic State militants wanted to wipe out people from Mosul. The question is, what does this have to do with the Quran? Is the Islamic State anything to do with the Quran?
No.
Are you willing to say Islamic State is anti-Islamic? Can you say that, please?
We didn't say it's anti-Islamic. We didn't, just because it has nothing to do with Islam.
So is it Islamic or not? Is Islamic State Islamic or not?
ISIS.
No.
So, Islamic State is not Islamic.
Let us speak.
Because he's speaking, there are many people here.
Khawarij.
What?
They're ISIS. Khawarij.
Yeah, they don't.
What is that? Sorry, I can't hear you.
Khawarij. They're ISIS.
Yeah. Are they Muslims or not? Are they Islamic or not? So clearly, according to the confession of this gentleman here, Islamic State is not Islamic.
Yes, Muslim.
Well done. Thank you.
That's like saying because there's Muslim grooming gangs, they're following the Quran. It doesn't mean that because they're doing something and they're Muslim, that means they're following the Quran unequivocally.
Well, whether they. Excuse me.
Politicians are flawed. Doesn't mean that they're following the Quran unequivocally. People can misinterpret the Quran. It even says that in the Quran. So the fact that you're saying that.
Okay, let's try and see if Islamic State people were misinterpreting the Quran.
All right,
when they went after the Christians in Mosul to kill them, to wipe them out, or force them to convert to Islam, were they being Islamic or not? Let's see.
Do you know what it says in the Quran? It says there's no compulsion in religion. You know what, do you know what that means?
Let's try.
You can't force anybody to be a Muslim.
Let's see if that's what the Quran says.
It says that. I'm telling you. It says that in the Quran.
I'm going to read to you now.
From what verse 3?
Yeah, what translation?
Surah At-Tawbah. Surah chapter 9. Verse 29. Fight against such of those. Please read. Fight against such of those who have been given the scripture as believe not in Allah. Those who believe not in Allah, nor the last day, and forbid not that which Allah has forbidden by His messenger. And follow not the religion of truth until they pay the tribute readily,
that's it.
Being brought low. No. Let's go through this.
Make a statement.
What's your point?
Excuse me, sir. Please learn to listen. If you can't, move on.
I'm not moving on because you're
Quran is asking, commanding Muslims. Instructing, commanding Muslims to fight.
Right, yeah.
On what basis? On what basis?
It says that in the Bible. Sorry.
On what basis? Fight. Fight against. Excuse me, please. Darren, one second. Fight against. Darren, please. So fight against those who believe.
You're right here, bro.
Darren. Darren, please. Fight against those.
We can pull up 1,000 Bible verses that are way worse.
Darren.
That doesn't even mean anything. You're shooting yourself in the foot.
Fight against those who believe not in Allah. Do you believe in Allah,
why
brother?
Why do you mean
I'm reading.
Read it.
I'm reading.
Read it.
I read the entire verse once. Right. Now I'm going through it step by step. Why are you afraid? Do you believe in Allah, brother?
I'm still afraid of who Allah is.
You don't even know who Allah is. And so clearly you would not believe in Islamic Allah.
He's a Christian.
But clearly he is a Christian. And therefore, he would come under the category of who? Muslims have been instructed to fight against. Let me go through. One second.
Which category?
The category of people who ought to be fought against.
What is that?
Fight against those who have been given the scripture as believe not in Allah, nor the last day. Do you believe in Islamic end time exposition, brother? You don't believe in that. They're coming after you to fight. If anyone wants to follow you, follow Islam. And forbid not that which Allah has forbidden by His messenger. Who does messenger mean here? So, whatever Muhammad says, you ought to follow, apparently. And if you don't, your Muslims have been instructed to fight against you.
For what reason?
And follow not. Follow the reasons I've given you so far.
No, you haven't.
If you don't follow Muhammad, if you don't follow Islam, They will come after you.
No, no. That's
what is the reason?
Carry on. Now you're making lies.
And follow not the religion.
Do you know what jizya is?
You don't know. What is jizya?
Are you willing to pay the jizya, sir?
You're talking to a Christian.
Let me ask you. Are you willing to pay a slave tax?
Slave tax.
A second class slave tax.
Can you listen to this man?
Yeah, let's read.
Let me contextualize.
And follow not the religion of truth until they pay tribute.
Okay, do you know what's the punishment?
Readily, being brought low.
Yeah.
You will be subdued.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
If look, yes.
Yeah, but
they're just waiting for that to happen.
Condition.
Yes.
Under what condition? Under what condition?
Yes.
Well, the conditions have been read so far. Haven't you been paying attention?
You
either should become a Muslim, follow Messenger, Muhammad, follow Islam, follow his religion, or you should be willing to be submissive before Muslims.
Okay, let me give you
if you don't do either of them, Muslims have been instructed to fight against you. Do you think that's a good idea, brother?
You're in an echo chamber. Listen to the answer.
Listen to me. You know, under the caliphate of Abu Bakr Siddiq, there are many Muslims who refuse to pay zakat. Do you know what's the punishment? There's a punishment for people who don't pay zakat, right? Similarly, there are those Jews and Christians, in this verse, it's not talking about fighting them on the account of religion, it's on the account that they're not paying the jizya, not on account of religion.
Yes.
All right.
They were treated
so
well.
The Muslims.
They
saw
Did you hear the answer the gentleman gave?
Don't say that, bro.
Did you hear the answer the gentleman gave? The gentleman said, this is against some other time. Do you believe in the Quran to be the eternal word of Islamic Allah, sir?
Of course.
Do you believe in that? Do you need to follow the Quran today? Do you need to follow the Quran today? Do you need to follow the Quran today? If you read this instruction, would you obey Islamic Allah or not? Do not run away. Would you obey the Islamic Allah or not?
You tell me which country is caliphate.
Excuse me, sir. Would you obey the Islamic Allah or not?
Listen to the answer.
Well, if your answer is this is only in Islamic caliphate, let me better tell you, of course, we would never let you do that here. Clearly. We are not fools to let you do that here. Clearly. But the question is, would you dare to do this anywhere? That's the question. Brother,
are you ready to listen?
If you live in Saudi Arabia, they'll come after you. Are you happy about this? They live and practice here. Are you a Muslim, sir?
Yes, I'm a Muslim.
You tell me. You're in London right now.
Good. He is a Muslim.
He's right.
Come here, please.
No, I'm here.
Where do you live, sir?
No, why do you want to know?
Where do you live? Where? No, not a particular town. Which country do you live in?
Talk about what you want to talk about, not where you live.
Which country do you live in?
I live in Alaska.
He lives in Alaska. Which country do you live in?
Yeah, I live in Alaska.
Yeah, I'm in Alaska.
Well, let me talk to someone who lives in the UK. Any Muslim who lives in the UK?
I live in North Pole.
You live in the UK?
No, North Pole.
You live in the North Pole.
Yeah.
Well, it has everything to do with what I'm talking about here, sir. You are living in a country here. Have you been forced to pay jizya here in the UK? How much tax do you pay? Oh, ho. Jizya. All right. Jizya is just the tax that the Muslims pay. Do the Muslims pay jizya?
No,
clearly, oh, wow. Don't run from one tree to another. Don't do that.
And do you know what's
the question? The question.
Many historians.
I asked the question. Whoa. Zechariah, please make sense. One question at a time. I asked the gentleman, do you pray?
No, I don't pay jizya.
Jizya.
No, I pay zakat, not jizya.
Yes.
Clearly, he does not.
I pay zakat, not jizya.
Listen to me carefully. Do you pay any tax as a Muslim?
Yes, I do.
Which is more than a tax that a Christian would pay.
No.
So the Christian and a Muslim would pay the same tax in a nation like ours, won't we? Christians and Muslims pay the same tax here, don't we? Don't we? Yes, in the UK, please. Yes.
I don't have any It's not 2.5.
Okay, you don't have anything and therefore you don't pay. That's fine. But the question I asked was simple. Are you ill-treated by the fact that you are a Muslim in a nation like ours? That's the question asked.
Hang on. So we're talking about a religious state.
Ours.
Religious state. This is a
democracy. Ours. Are you ill-treated?
You're listening to the
because you are a Muslim, are you a second-class citizen in the UK?
Listen to the answer.
But in an Islamic state, you would be, wouldn't you?
It's the same question.
If a Christian... Wait a second. Brother, they are confessing here. The confession is simple.
Okay.
In the UK... We do not give partial treatment to a Muslim. We don't undermine them. Just because, wait a second. Just by the fact that they are Muslims, no one ill-treats them. They pay the same tax. He can change into a Christian tomorrow and would end up paying the same amount of tax as long as income remains the same. So his religion does not determine his tax level. But in Islam, what do you find? In an Islamic country, Islamic caliphate, like what he said, if you are a Christian, you ought to be paying more. How much? How much do you pay? How much jizya do you pay, sir? What jizya percentage, sir? If you don't know, don't say more or less. Keep your mouth shut, sir. Excuse me, sir. If you don't know, if you don't know, if you let me educate you, let's read the statement.
You ask me what's the percentage. I don't know.
Let's read here.
What's the percentage?
Let's read here.
What's the percentage?
Let's read here. One second. Let's read here. And follow not the religion of truth. But you don't analyze. Let me try and help you analyze. And follow not. So is this a waste of time? In English?
It is if you don't talk to somebody.
In English, is this a waste of time? I am happy for anyone to read the English Bible. Are you happy for me to read the English Quran?
Not if you don't know Arabic.
Is this the Quran?
Is
this the Quran?
The true Quran.
Why is the Islamic Dawah Society spreading this lie if this is not the Quran? Is this the Quran?
It's an interpretation of the meaning of the Arabic that the Quran was revealed.
Is it, this is an interpretation of the power of two to the power of five of the Quran. My dear friends, you want to understand if there are double treatment or not? Read here, please. Follow not the religion of truth until they pay.
Genghis Khan.
Until. Please, one at a time, please listen.
What's the number of the chapter?
One minute.
Surah 9, Ayah 29. Until they pay that tribute readily, being brought low. Being brought. Are you listening?
No, because I've heard it already, bro. He's going to get the Arabic. He knows Arabic. He'll explain it.
Being brought low. How can he be brought low through a tax? Being brought low.
Listen.
It says being brought low by being made to pay this jizya, sir.
You're translating.
Being brought low.
He's a car, not jizya.
I know. I know. You are an elitist. Islam.
Did you know zakat?
Elitist.
Then the Christians and Jews
thank you.
Jizya. That's a fact.
Please come here. Please come here.
I'm here.
It's COVID.
Until they pay the tribute. Being brought low. How exactly do you bring a Christian low by making them pay a tax? Please explain to me. How do you bring them low?
Like this one, they don't believe the right.
How do you bring them low?
If a Muslim doesn't pay the tax, they get the punishment. Did you know that?
The question is simple. How do you bring someone low by making them pay a tax?
You make what?
How do you bring them low?
You make what?
Any answer?
What was the question?
How do you bring them low?
How do you bring them low here?
Excuse me, here everyone pays similar tax structure. Don't worry about this. Have you got any special tax structure, sir?
A lower tax. I think you'd be happy if you had a lower tax to pay.
Like at least the tax is 1%.
How do you bring someone low by forcing them to pay a tax? How do you force them? How do you bring them low? Any answer whatsoever?
Kind of
nothing.
Tax?
You call the police.
To protect them.
Nothing.
Police.
You don't pay tax.
Oh yeah. Don't pay tax. In an Islamic state, they call the police because they respect the police.
You get your possessions taken away. You don't pay tax. Yeah. You get revoked. That's what happens.
So go after. Go on, brother. Did you want to say something?
The question is why do Christians have to pay more than the Muslims?
And why do you? Yeah, sure. And why do you think they have to pay more? Where did you get that from?
No.
Because the real Christianity and the Jews, they are quite happy about the small tax.
Under the Muslim Caliphate. Not by many historians. Montgomery Watt, for example.
Like you, forcing the people.
Not what I read in the Quran.
You need to pay tax 30%.
Historians didn't rather...
He is running... Can you see this? No, please, please look at him.
COVID law. That's what he's doing.
No. He's still near the other people there. He is moving away and away after doing a Google search. Moving away and away.
I just said to you.
The question asked was simple. How do you bring someone low by forcing them to pay a tax? How many? How do you?
Should be there. We're just trying to say that the jizya.
How do you bring someone low?
Let me give you a question.
Did you know that Muslims are many?
No question. How do you bring someone low? How do you bring someone low? How do you bring someone low? By forcing them to pay a tax.
Force.
How do you bring them low?
Force. From where do you bring the word of force?
You pay tax in the UK.
If you live in an uncontrolled Islamic state, you have to follow the law.
The question is simple. How do you force and bring someone low?
Wasting time. They're just shouting like...
Can I tell you one thing?
Any answer whatsoever? How do you bring them low?
Muslims are obliged to pay zakat. Jews and Christians are obliged to pay jizya. Both of them face punishment.
Question. How do you bring those who are non-Muslims low? No answer whatsoever. I'm asking you a simple question. How do you bring non-Muslims low? No answer. My dear friends.
That happens in the UK.
In the UK, are there two kinds of tax systems, sir? Please come here.
Same way as the police.
Please come here. In the UK, are there two different tax systems? That's not the question. The question is, are there two different tax systems? Is there a Muslim tax system versus a Christian tax system? Is there?
No.
Clearly not. But clearly, according to Islam, Muslims pay a different tax system and Christians pay a different tax system. Why is that, sir? Why is that, sir?
Pay more as a God.
Excuse me. You are telling me nonsenses because read to me carefully. It says, until they pay the tribute readily, being brought low. No answer. No answer. No answer. No answer. Yes, sir. How do you bring a Christian low? By making them pay a particular tax. How do you bring them low?
Sorry?
How do you bring them low? How do you bring them low?
You're just going around in circle. We've been answered 5 times by now.
How do you bring them low?
Circle.
How do you bring them low?
Do you pay tax in the UK?
I do.
Do you pay tax in the UK?
Yes, I do.
Why are you not opposing the government?
No.
That's not the point.
That's not the point. Double standards. Double standards. For something else? Oh, no, it's okay.
Try your best.
For Islam? No. Oppression.
Question.
Muslims pay more than Christians.
Question. Question. Question.
He's been refuted 5 times already. He's going circle. Everyone knows him in the park to be refuted every day. And he's done same arguments.
Question. Running away. Question.
He just agreed with me, actually. That we tell you talk to him. Look, I said to him, and he said, we pay more tax to you. I said, well, if you're in an Islamic state and you're earning a lot more than me and they got me using me like a slave, obviously the monkey pay going to be more than me, but the principle is that I'm supposed to pay more than you.
Yes.
So I said, that's not a fair point you're making.
Yeah.
If you're earning $100,000 and I'm earning $20,000, obviously you're going to pay more than me.
Yeah.
But as an absolute. But the principle is, I am supposed to pay more than you. When you cut the differentials, I'm supposed to pay more.
Percentage-wise.
Percentage-wise, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
So the problem clearly is, Christians would be subjugated, would be brought low through the system. Either become a second-class citizen, not citizen, second-class slave,
yeah.
Or become a Muslim.
He just agreed with me. When I said that to him, now I talk to you. So he actually agreed with me.
Yeah. And he ran away.
Yeah.
So, my dear friends, Islam is a load of lies. Give up on Islam and come to the Lord Jesus.